Multiple exposure photography is the act of taking multiple exposures into one final frame, taking multiple pictures and blending them into one. For those of us of a certain age, we may recall that back in the days of shooting film, to do this, you would take one picture and then cock the shutter without advancing the film, take a second exposure, possibly even a third and more, and then develop the film and see what you got. Odds are it probably didn't turn out that great. In the modern era, you can do this in Photoshop. It's easy, just a couple of layers in Photoshop, stack them together, blend them together, and off you go. Well, with Lumix cameras in the multiple exposure mode, we've brought back that idea of doing it in the old film way, in camera, but putting a modern twist on it. What we can do in the Lumix camera is combine up to four different exposures that you can either shoot all back to back, or load up one original photo that you shot earlier to start with, and then add on top of that. So let's take a look at how this works. Go into the menu, starting from the photo menu, and then navigate over to Others, Photo 2, and finally to Multiple Exposure. From here, we can start the exposure, but we'll go through the other options first. The first option is called Auto Gain. This allows the camera to adjust the gain as the photo is being built. It may darken or brighten the exposure to make them blend together more seamlessly. Whether this is a good idea or not for your photo is going to be up to your situation, so you might want to try both. I'm going to leave it on for this photo. The overlay option allows you to choose a pre-existing raw photo, and it does have to be raw, not a JPEG, that's on your SD card that you can then add other photos to. We're going to leave that off for now, although I am going to come back to this later. Let's go ahead and start. Now I'm ready to start building the composite. I'm going to take the first photo of this beautiful anamorphic lens here, but it's a little bit too bright here in the studio, so I'm going to turn this light off. I'll be right back. All right, this is looking pretty good. I'm going to darken it down just a tiny bit more and then get that first shot. All right, there's the first exposure. You can see now it says next, retake, or exit. If I like the photo and I'm ready to move on, I hit next. If I want to redo it, of course, I can hit retake or cancel the entire procedure. Let's go ahead to next. And now I'm going to move this lens out of the way. And you can see here that we're seeing a ghost of the image that we just shot. And then I'm going to drop down these fairy lights that I have behind it. In a normal situation, of course, you would simply pick up the camera and recompose, but for the sake of this demo, I'm just dropping something else into frame. I'm going to go ahead and defocus those lights a little bit, make them nice and bokeh ball-ish, and then make them a little bit darker. It's feeling a little bit too bright, so let's make them a little bit darker on there, build up the composite the way that I want it, and that's looking pretty good. Let's go ahead and fire off a frame. And there we go. I dig it. If I want to retake that, of course I can, but I'm actually going to add another exposure to this. Let's hit next again. I'm going to move the lights just a little bit. Let's move them to a different position here. And I'll even change the focus on them, make them a little bit smaller on there. Make them just a little bit darker still. And let's take the shot. There we go. I love it. I'm happy with that result, so I'll exit out of here. The final composite will be built, and we're ready to go. Now I'm going to build up a similar shot, but this time starting with an existing photo. Back into the menu, I'll choose Overlay and set that to On, Start, and then choose a photo that I shot earlier. If you're wondering how this shot was made, watch the video called Live View Composite. I'm going to go ahead and start with this, and then set the lens back into place. Clearly, the exposure is going to have to change in here, so I'll go ahead and brighten up the shot, maybe open up the aperture a little bit, and refocus that. I think that's pretty good. Take the picture, and there we've got it. And those are the options you have for multiple exposure photography in the Lumix camera. Panasonic.